The only way you gon' get wiser is through trial and error. You gotta fuck up.
Ain't no other way.
You gotta, ain't no other way. That God made it fucked up for us, but you gotta touch that stove and burn your hand. Shout out to the hood for giving me some tough-ass skin. Like, when you just been through so much, you don't even know how to cry. I ain't gonna lie, I don't feel like it's safe for nobody in no hood. Like, nobody that's really successful, because in the hood, at the end of the day, motherfuckers still hungry, you know what I'm saying? But if I go too far and not bring them with me, they'll show me how much we not friends, you know what I'm saying? But friends, they don't give a fuck if you bring them with you, whatever. Like, I'm rooting for you. Like, another nigga would have been laid down, but I don't know how to, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's presidential. I lost all feelings. I used to think I never would.
I
lost all feelings and sunk the ass back to the hood.
Alright, you know, now that the smoke break is over, we having fun out there up on the roof in the bay. You know, Jackboy, he's still in the building. He's still hanging out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know, it's always good to have Florida here kicking it, catching these vibes for real. We done shared some stories, man. We done talked about these haters for real.
For sure.
You know, which is very necessary, you know.
Facts.
You got to learn how to deal with that. You gave me some words of advice while we were up there. He was like, everybody ain't your friend.
Everybody ain't.
Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for
That's
sure.
something to live by.
Facts.
You only 25 years old.
Yeah.
You know, but you've seen a lot. You've done a lot. Where you want to be by 30?
By 30,
yeah,
I want to be, I don't really want to even say where I want to be because I feel like that's going to limit it. I might get there and be like, damn, I should have said something bigger. You know what I mean?
Yeah, not for sure.
I just want to be bigger than and doing better than what I'm doing right now. That's all. Like, every year, just bigger and better. So if next year I make 200 million by 30, I need to make more than, you know what I mean? I just need to keep on going up. So I don't really want to say where I want to be or how much I want to get or what, because I feel like that's really, I'm shortchanging myself. I don't know how big I get. We don't know how far this will go.
No, that's a fact. That's a fact. Well, now that we at What's Hood, man, Hoodclips, we make it happen. I got to get your definition of hood. What is hood to Jackboy?
Hood is,
if you had to define it, what is it?
Hood is, if I had to define it, I would say, like, somewhere that's like urban-ish, you know what I'm saying? Like ghetto-ish.
Sure.
Like ghetto-ish, like street-ish, like more hip-hop type people live there. Like hood ain't necessarily like a black or nothing. Like, oh, black people or projects. It could be just black, white, it could be anything, just hood, like just any, like just more like the hip-hop. A bit could be kinda in the suburbs and be a little hood, like, you know what I mean? That's why you see some of them good kids still have, you know what I mean? It's just, I don't know, like, just the ghetto-ness in them, I guess, or the just the little ratchet stuff. That's the hood, like, I feel.
That's the hood.
The little ratchet in everybody.
Just a little.
Yeah, everybody got it in them.
A little ratchet in you.
Yeah, some people got it a little more than others, you know what I mean?
No, for sure. What do you say is your ticket out of the hood? Because, you know, in the hood growing up, right, everybody play football, bro. That's what it is. Or you run track in school, you know what I'm saying? Or you play basketball. What would you say was your ticket? Like, you knew early on rap was going to be your ticket out of the hood?
Nah, I definitely didn't know. I definitely didn't know. I just knew I was going to do something. Like, so I was like, all right, whatever it's going to be, like, I'm going to go hard at it. So I didn't know if it would have been, to be honest, crimes, to be honest.
Yeah.
Go be a whatever athlete or a trapper, but I just knew whatever I do, I'm gonna go hard. Like,
Were you an athlete early on?
Yeah, I used to play a little football.
Everybody played a little. You know what I'm saying? Where you played at? Do you remember?
I played Little League. I played Little League all around Broward and shit.
Yeah,
like
can
that.
We play some? Was it Deerfield? We played. Back in the day.
Oh, yeah, Deerfield.
I think they were like green and yellow.
Yeah, Deerfield Rattlers.
Yeah. Okay, that's who that was.
For sure. Yeah,
we like, well, ain't gonna lie to them boys, ran through
them
our ass.
Them boys raw. Them boys, yeah.
They definitely ran through us. But you know what? You know, coming from the hood, it installs some values in you, man.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? I think you can take stuff that you learn in the hood that you use in everyday life.
Yeah, facts.
You know, especially as a hustler. You know what I'm saying? I think Hov said it best. He's like, if I could sell, you know, kilos of coke, I'm guessing I could sell CDs.
Facts.
You know, what have you taken from the hood that you've applied to this music industry that's helped you be successful?
Things I took from the hood that I applied to the music industry. Just being yourself. Like, motherfuckers in the hood don't give a fuck what other people think. And with this music industry that's big, like, because you get caught up in what, and then it's a yeah. lot of opinions. And in the hood, you a motherfucker walk out with no shoes on in the front of you and, hey, you all ready to go to the store?
Yeah.
Like, that's just some hood shit. And yeah. you learn, like, early, like, learn how to joke. Like, motherfucker, well, go put on shoes. So you been had tough skin. You just been ready for it. So that's a good thing. Shout out to the hood for giving me some tough-ass skin. Like,
you gonna need tough skin.
Yeah, so it's like, I've been there, done that. This Lil Jack that used to walk with no shoes, like, he yeah. got the M's. Like, yeah, so you already, sure. you just, that's good thing to bring from the hood. Like, the... Like, just the don't give that a fuck attitude, that, that confidence, that thick skin, that, that yeah, nigga, I'm here, like.
And not showing it, because you know you're going to get clowned if
yeah,
you do.
Yeah, yeah, for sure, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, he made you cry.
Yeah, for sure. You yeah, you got to, yeah, you got to.
You
yeah,
got to hide that.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. You don't even got to hide it. When you just been through so much, you don't even know how to cry. Mm. All right, but like, how the fuck, like, all right, that happened. Or like, you know what I'm saying? See, some people experience death so much, it's like, damn, whoop the whoop just died. It'd be like, damn.
Kind of desensitized to it.
Yeah, you get used to it. Or it's like, damn, I just had another bad day. You have 10 bad days in a row. You ready for the 11th one? It's like, fuck, I'm crying on the 11th day. Mm. Nigga, you ain't used to this by now. You been here before. Tighten up. Let's get this shit going. Like, so, yeah.
Well, would you say, you know, being from the hood, you know, being seeing stuff, sometimes you can become desensitized to it and just be like, that's just another day in the hood. But, I mean, do you feel like it's safe? In your hood, would you say? I know you probably safe.
Yeah. Or, I ain't gonna lie, I don't feel like it's safe for nobody in no hood. Like, nobody that's really successful, because in the hood, at the end of the day, motherfuckers still hungry, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, you could go there and vibe, but for how long? Like, I feel like you really gonna trick yourself off the street sooner or later, because sooner it's gonna be a young one that come up that just don't respect you, or it's gonna be a homeboy that just feel like you ain't doing enough, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, why risk that? Like, the goal is to make it out, you know what I'm saying? Not stay here and chill forever.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Because it has been a lot of artists, you know what I'm saying, when you look at the X, the Nipsey Hussles, the, you know, whatever you see, like, damn, the boys is where they was from.
Facts. And it's always gonna be like that, because motherfuckers from where you from might be like, damn, like that's a whoop-de-whoop. Mm-hmm. Then they gonna be like, damn, he ain't doing shit for me, though. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm like, yeah, he's stunning for the city, but fuck, I'm still hungry. Like, yeah. So you gotta be aware of that when you getting money, and you gotta move properly. Like, you can't get too comfortable. You can't feel like, damn, like, they friends. Nah, hood just like the industry. This shit is business. You hear me? It's business. Like, your only friends is your mom and the motherfuckers you see in your house. Your girlfriends, your people that's every day. Like, them your friends. Motherfuckers that just, nah, them my associates. Them people I know, like, but them ain't my friends. Like, if I go too far and not bring them with me, they'll show me how much we not friends. You know what I'm saying? But friends, they don't give a fuck if you bring them with you, whatever. Like, I'm rooting for you. Like, I want you to win. Like, I don't care right now. You shit on me, I'll be like, I want you to win. Like, I'm rooting for you. Like,
has there ever been a time where people kind of didn't believe in you or expect that you was going to win?
All the time. That's Jack. But that's why I always, like, they'd be like, damn, how he keep on doing it? Yeah. But that's why it'd be the haters. That's why I keep them with a job. They think of shit. They got to think of shit. It's like, because I keep on doing shit. It's like, what the fuck? Like,
yeah. Like why he still standing?
Yeah, like, damn, like, or damn, like, oh, he going to still drop another song? Or damn, he still, like,
yeah.
Or damn, he going to buy another check? Like, damn, shit, like, bruh. Like another nigga would have been laid down, but I don't know how to, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's a fact, because sometimes, you know, we get to a point where you think that, you know what I'm saying, people always believe in you. But sometimes people, you know, they dig right. They decide when, or, you know, I know you probably had some surprising moments like, you too, bruh?
Did I? Like, oh my God. Some moments like, oh, but I don't gonna lie, never be too surprised, because I don't put nothing past nobody. So I told you this business, nobody friends. Yeah. So I come in the relationship feeling like, nah, we ain't friends until we build enough and go through certain shit. And I feel like, all right, I could consider this person a brother now. And then, like, I could consider this person a homie until I let you in my house and chilling with me, and you ain't really, nothing. Because it's like, at any moment, people could change up on you. People could, so you got to be aware of that. So when it do happen, it don't hurt you as much, or it be like, damn, like.
Yeah.
Like, okay. And then you just roll with the punches. You, okay. Like, that shit happened with a lot of people, like, but it's like, I expected that from you. You weak, you know what I'm saying? You weak, like. you need a motherfucker to do certain things, or you need clout, or you need to, like, you know what I'm saying, you weak. Like, I expected that from you. But the strong ones, they still, you know what I'm saying, holding it down. Like,
who would you say with some of your biggest supporters that's always held you down, bro?
My biggest supporter that always helped me down is my brother. Mm. Like, I feel like my brother, my biggest supporter.
Your big brother?
Yeah, my big brother. I feel like that's my biggest supporter, always helped me down. Like,
yeah.
But it's a lot of, like, fans, too. Like, I got some fans that's die hard. Like,
I heard you talk about your fans.
Yeah, they...
Like, they'll come... They, like, you know...
They on your ass.
You know what I'm saying? The only ones that have got some fans that'll come get your
yeah,
ass.
Yeah, like, for sure. Like,
your fans will come get them.
Yeah, from the biggest to the smallest. Like, yeah, they might not... They might not outnumber your fans or whatever, but they gonna hold it down. Like, and they gonna, it's the consistent ones. Like, they gonna hold it down. It's to the point I went to seeing them holding it down so much. I'm like, oh
chill,
I fuck with this. Yeah, chill out. I fuck with this one though. Like, this nigga gonna hold it down. Like, it's yeah. a certain ones. So shout out to them too. Like, the ones that's like, oh yeah, y'all got Jack. Y'all got Jack. Fuck. And then that just know, like.
Yeah, when you creating this music, Jack, you know what I'm saying? Everybody know. I really feel like, me personally, when I listen to a song, I want it to do something to me.
Yeah, for sure.
I want it to either make me turn.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? Make me want to, you know, work a little harder, feel inspired, go get some money. Like, what is it when you create records, you want people to feel what?
Exactly what you just said. It's crazy. I even got a song called Work a Little Harder. And then it's on there. So it's like, exactly what you said. Like, that's what I'd be in the mindset. I go in there and be like, I go off the vibe. I don't really, like, I just play any beat. It might be a girl beat, and I'd be like, you know what? I might do a girl song today, and I might do a million girl songs that one day. And then it's like, yeah, I'm not going to use all of them, but I go off how I'm feeling. I don't force the vibe. I don't force, like, oh, I need a club record. Nah, you ain't never going to get a club record like that. Just wait till the day come that you turn and you feeling it and get all the club records in. And then, so I might do like 5 club songs in one day. Like, and then I might do 3 real songs. I might be going through something in life, and I might do 2 songs or 3 like songs like in one day, like some, and talking to them though. Like, so you just go off the vibes in the moments. Like,
the vibes in the moments, I could tell, are key for you.
Yeah, for
sure. You know, if you ain't feeling something,
for sure,
you just ain't going to do it.
Facts.
At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? That's very important for a lot of people to know, too. And then you got to know when to say, fuck that shit, I ain't doing it. Facts. Has there been times where it's like, you know, the vibe ain't here right now? I feel like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's half, but I tend to, and then, like, I just be like, and then I'll try to...
Still work through it.
Yeah, thug it out. But it's times where the vibe just be like, nah, but I don't never really too much force the vibe. Like,
yeah.
If I'm really feeling off or whatever, I'll just, nah, I ain't forcing the vibe. If I'm not supposed to be doing it right now, like my soul ain't connecting with it. Mm. Like, regardless if it's working out, like, or regardless if it's gonna, it could be some, you call me and be like, hey, Jack, let's go do the podcast. Or Jack, meet me down the street at your restaurant. Or if I don't feel it, like, as soon as I'm about to go, if a vibe come up on me, like, or what, I'm not going. Like, I'm not, I gotta feel the vibe. Like, I don't force it. Like, I go with the flow. Like, hold on, why I'm feeling like this, God talking to me, like, like, that's how I go with it. Like,
I can feel that. I can feel that for sure. Yo, what is one thing that people, you know, like, I see, you hear a lot. You know what I'm saying? You see a lot. It's like, man, I wish people would know this. You know what I mean? Like, something that's a misconception about Jackboy that's like, man, this is really me. You know what I mean? Some people don't know, but they perceive you as one thing, would you say?
I don't really be feeling like that. I don't really care what people then be
perceive.
Like, damn, I hope they look at me as I'm real. I hope they knew that I did this for this.
Yeah, or really did this for that person. Or I was this or I was that.
It's a lot of situations. Really, it's a lot of situations where I could come out and say it like, bro, I did this for you. I did this for your mom. Why did this for your kid? But I just be holding it in, and it's like, me and you know that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Me and you know.
That's some grown man shit, though.
Yeah, me and you know deep down. Y'all could do my little petty kid shit, too, so, but
I'm
me
pretty
and
sure
you
got receipts
as
you
long
could.
As me and you know, though, deep down, like, all right, this is real, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was the flawed one, like, I be cool with that. Like, I don't even really give a fuck too much about, you know what I'm saying? As long as me and you know, like, but it's a lot of moments I could be like, bro, I done...
Yeah.
For niggas' mamas, bro. I done.
You can't be around.
Yeah, years I done born. Yeah. I done spent over 100 racks receipts, like, on the gang. Like, not me, on the gang. Over 100. Yeah, like. So it's like, at points like that, it just be like, we know. Like, man, I ain't got. You'd be like, nah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When it's said and done, though, Jackboy, I really feel like you want to leave an impression on this game.
Yeah, for sure. When it's said and done, I feel like I'm going to leave an impression on the game. And then I feel like that shit just off rip. Like, that shit inevitable. Like, that shit going to happen. Like, it's destined. Like, yeah. It's they can see it. Like, we don't know how. We don't know if it's going to be with the music. We don't know if it's going to be with the Jackwoods. We don't know the Pierre restaurant. But we just know, like, Jada got some, you know what I'm saying? He one of them ones. Like, he ain't playing. Like, he not playing at all. Like, he finna find a way. Like, he finna find a way. Yeah, for sure.
I noticed that, I don't know. I don't know if it's because of when you get a little older, you get a little wiser. Because as a jit, like, say 18-year-old Jackboy versus 25-year-old Jackboy.
It really ain't, if you get older, you get a little wiser. It don't got nothing to do with that. I feel like I'm so wise right now because at an early age, I fucked up. The only way you gonna get wiser is through trial and error. You gotta fuck up.
Ain't no other way.
Ain't no other way. That God made it fucked up for us, but you gotta touch that stove and burn your hand. You have to understand that shit gets hot. If you don't do it, if somebody just telling you that shit hot, it's gonna be, now you 20 years old and feeling like you know everything. Like, man, that stove don't get hot. You gotta touch it early on, like, to see early. Like, and sometimes that shit might get, some people die, be weird situations, but I ain't gonna lie, the fuck ups in life is what made me successful. Like, my fuck ups, not all the good shit I thought about, not the shit I planned, not the shit that I fucked up on, or the shit that I went to jail, or the shit, like, damn, this homeboy, all my fuck ups, like, that's what got me right. Like, damn, my homeboy crossed me. It's possible for people to do that. Damn, I never thought it was possible for a nigga like this close to cross. Like, you go to thinking, or you be like, damn, I lost this money doing this. All right, you go to thinking, like, damn, all right, I can't lose this much doing this no more. Yeah. All right, let me put this shit in restaurants. Or you go to thinking, like,
I can't go broke like this no more.
Like, hell no, let me get this restaurant. Motherfuckers gonna eat forever. And that'll spend money on this. And that'll, you gotta fuck up. That's the only way. If you don't fuck up, you not gonna know what you doing wrong. You not.
I heard somebody say a quote the other day, you can't spell millionaire without a couple L's.
You can't. That's facts. You cannot spell millionaire without a couple L's.
You know what I'm saying? And you know what's big too? I'd love to ask you this right now because you've learned a lot. Like, we talked about investments. You talk about the restaurant. We're going to get into that restaurant too.
Yeah, for sure.
But 25-year-old you, what would you tell 16-year-old you if you could go back right now and tell 16-year-old you something right now? What would it be? Tell brother, prepare him for where we going, what's going on.
You ain't got no friends. This a business. That's what I'll tell 16-year-old me. You ain't got no friends. Stop trying to be. That's what a lot of my fuck ups, trying to be too real. Like, I like, nah, bro, I'm finna ride for my dog. Like, I done went to jail behind this shit, did years, did. So it's like, bro, you ain't got friends. Like, focus on you. You know what I'm saying? This shit a business. Like, get to the money. That's it. Get to the money. You ain't got friends. Like, and don't be ashamed or none of that. You gotta let a motherfucker know that sometimes. Like, hold on, like, nah, y'all good. Y'all go. Yeah. Instead of being like, damn, you know what? This my dog. I'm finna ride with him. Or this my dog. I'm finna go do this. Or sometimes niggas put themselves in situations like, I'm finna go spin. I'm finna go whatever.
Right.
And that don't even be your dog for real. Like, that might be the same motherfucker that tell on you when you go spin about him. Like, so it's like, you gotta think, like, man, fuck that. Like, ain't no friends in this shit. Like, we was not born together. That shit is really real. Like,
yeah. And we gonna die separately.
We gonna die separately unless we die on some sucker friend trying to be fake. Like, nah. It's like, nah, I'm about to move smart. Hopefully you move smart. If you keep on moving smart, yeah, you could sooner later become a brother. But all that friendship, fuck is a friend. Like, what the fuck? Nigga been crossed by friends. This shit been going on before me for years. So it's like, fuck's a friend. Nah, but it's niggas that turn into brothers. You like, oh yeah, like, this a brother. Like, this a little deeper than a friend. Like,
yeah,
we ain't got the same mom, but this deeper than that.
But some of that shit do be tough, though.
Yeah, fact.
Mentally, I think sometimes, like, you know, we do a lot of shit. It's easier said than done. Because you do feel it. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, when you spend a lot of time, years with a nigga, you invest time, you invest energy, you got real love for somebody, you know what I'm saying? It kind of be like, damn, it hit different versus a nigga you don't fuck with.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Sure,
or a person
sure.
you don't fuck
for
with
sure,
in general.
For sure.
So when somebody, whether it's somebody your family, whether it's your girl, whether it's your dog that you rock with for years, it hit different.
Yeah, for sure.
When that shit be like, damn, you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure. But you know.
Do you regret anything? Do you feel like, oh, man.
I don't regret nothing because, like I said, the fuck ups is what made me successful. So I needed some of them fuck ups. I needed to be heartbroken by a friend, by a bitch, by a business. I needed that. I needed to be crossed. Like, if you ain't never been crossed, you might get crossed when you got Bill Gates money. That shit, you don't want to get crossed then. I'd rather you cross me now when this shit still, when I'm still figuring it out. You know what I'm saying?
And, you needed to be sat down in jail.
Yeah, I
so
needed
it. So that you could
it.
Realize how to move it. Outside of that
so,
motherfucker.
Yeah, I needed it. I needed to be sat down in jail so I could see them wasn't my friends. Why motherfuckers ain't sending niggas this? You needed that. Some people don't understand that. Some people be like, damn, my girl rode with me and my... But you got to remember all them moments or all them times, everything you thought about in jail. Like, damn, my niggas could... I can't even get one of my niggas to visit me, and I'm 10 minutes away from home. Like, you got to remember that.
You wasn't even, like, out of the state. You was...
Like, not my last one, so you got to remember that. Like, it's like, you come home, it's like, yeah, damn, we still cool, we still... But I'm on some different shit. Like, yeah, you going to be mad sooner or later because a nigga ain't trying to kick the bobo with bullshit. Like, I'm tired of drinking liquor and chilling. I'm on some... Bitch, I got my liquor license.
Trying
you
want to
buy
some shit.
Yeah, you want to buy some liquor from me?
Yeah.
You motherfuckers started drinking it. You can buy some liquors from me. I got liquor license now. Yeah, this shit be like 90,000, 80,000 in some states. Yeah, we on a different timing. Like, that's how we coming. Like, different timing. Like,
so you now, bro, speaking of different timing, speaking of owning some shit, you know, shout out to Backwoods.
Yeah, for sure. Shout out
you got
Backwoods.
A good working relationship
yeah,
with them.
For sure. For
you
sure.
know what I'm saying? Jackwoods out.
Jackwoods, yeah.
You know, I smoked on it. We both smoked on it.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
It's an amazing product.
For sure. I'm high right now.
You feel me?
For sure.
And then now we talking restaurants.
Restaurants, fast.
And what's crazy about it, you know what I'm saying? You represent for the Zoe, the Haitian community, real heavy.
Yeah, for
you know
sure.
what I'm saying? That's a community, man. That's I ain't gonna lie to you. I don't know a Haitian that don't work hard.
Yeah. Facts.
One thing I know about people from Haiti, but they gonna put in that work.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Is that something that you feel like is innate, that you was just born with that hustle spirit? Like, yo, I gotta go create. I gotta hustle.
Yeah, facts. Because you just know, like, I feel like anybody, like, say, Haitians, Africans, Mexicans,
Jamaicans,
Puerto Ricans, anybody that's not from the U.S., when you come here, like, when you actually experience that shit in another country, then you come here, you be like, damn, like, it could be worse. You know what I'm saying?
It's the appreciation.
Yeah, you appreciate it a little more. You like, damn, it's bad. Like, damn, I might not know how to pay my rent, or damn, I might not... But it could be worse. Like,
this shit ain't that hood. Making them fake weights.
Yeah,
it's something different.
This shit, like, you blessed. Like, you go to noticing it. Like, you go to, or even when you go through them jail situations, like, all that shit, you like, man, it could be worse. Like you gotta, that's why some of them fuck ups, it builds you and it gets you tough for some of them moments you gonna go through in life when you gotta be tough. Know what I'm saying? You like, man, I've been in my cell for 23 hours a day. Like, it could be worse. Like, this little shit, this shit ain't nothing. Like, to a nigga, I done been where the CO shake up your food, then give it to you. Like, it could be worse. Like, I get to eat this now? Like, man, fuck that. This shit small to me. My little problems ain't nothing. This nigga still dealing with that. Bitch probably shake up their food today, and now they got to eat their rice with their fruits, with their this, with their that. Like, yeah, it could be worse.
Well, you done seen some crazy shit in there. What was some of the craziest shit you done seen?
I done seen too much crazy shit, so it's...
Niggas shaking up the food for
their
kids.
I done seen crazy shit. But you know... I ain't gonna lie, a lot of the COs, I kind of made my time a little harder than it was supposed to be because I was an asshole. And I don't just like...
Was it? Like, were you an asshole because you was hurt?
It was not
or
an
you
asshole.
You going through something? What was,
it probably like- was. I don't know. I don't understand it. But I just felt like the authority, like, I ain't like how they try to, like, I understand you, like, you got more authority than a nigga, but don't try to act like you just over a nigga. I ain't like that. And so I used to always headbutt with them, like, the COs down south be real disrespectful. They might be like, "Jit, go in the room." Like, who the fuck you talking to?
Man.
Like, yeah, like, know what I'm saying? Give me some respect. I'm gonna give you some respect. Like, don't talk. And I used to always have that problem, and that shit used to always lead me to fight. Like, I got in a big fight in Broward Jail because of that with like 5 COs. Like, that shit used to always lead me to that. Like, because it's like, nah, y'all ain't gonna talk to me crazy. Like, know what I'm saying? Fuck that. Like,
yeah.
But now it's like, man.
Treat me like I'm somebody.
Yeah, treat me like I'm somebody. Then it's like, I know I can't, my pride won't never let me get past that. Like, I will always get jumped by them. So it's like, you know what? Let me stop putting myself in this situation. Because I know, like, my pride, every time in jail, they, hey, Jit, I'm up, man, fuck. Like, I wouldn't give a fuck how much money I got or, like, just let it go. It'd be like, nah, fuck you. Like,
yeah.
So it's like, I know my pride won't let me get past that. So I ain't even going to put myself in that fucked up ass situation no more. It's like, Nah, that's just, that ain't a situation I'm vibing with. Like, hell no.
Bro, a lot of people don't identify their pride and realize, like, damn, this situation could have been different. But I was in my pride. I was like, nah, nigga, yeah, he stepped on my fucking shoe, nigga.
Yeah, for
you know
sure.
what I'm saying? Like, pride can put you in a situation.
Yeah, for
but to
sure.
be able to identify that and say, look, man, my pride was in the way.
Yeah.
I you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
Because pride get a lot of niggas killed out here real
yeah,
easy.
Yeah, for sure. But you got to know when, like, not to be stupid. And you just know. Like, you just know. But with that pride shit, I feel like that shit got bad for me. Just that's another thing. So jail did some good, then jail did some bad. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it did good with getting my mindset right, but with the pride shit, you know, you can't let nothing really slide in there. So you be so defensive and so,
you
know,
let a nigga take your food, like, yeah, you let a nigga take your butt,
or you
like
be
that.
So like ready, like, and it be like, damn. Sometimes it ain't even gotta be like that. So hopefully, as I grow older, I grow out that stage where a motherfucker might just be like, now it's like if you see me walking down the street, you just be like, fuck you, Jackboy, and you cross the street. I don't give a fuck. I'm on some other. But if you say that in my face, I still don't know how to not hit you. You know what I mean?
Because you seen you.
Yeah, it's like. So
don't wait to be something.
Yeah, so it's like, I'm trying to get to the stage where I could, a bit could tell me it right now on an interview like this, a podcast, and I'm just like, yeah, that's cool. Like,
yeah.
I'm trying to get to that stage. I'm trying to grow into that. Like, right. But it's still, yeah, that shit hard.
I can see you be like, well, I ain't going to be too many more of your pussy ass niggas.
We yeah, going to. Yeah, that shit be hard.
It be hard.
That shit be hard. It be hard.
But you know what? I feel like you're doing a good job of it, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And for you, I feel like what you're trying to create with these businesses, you know, I feel like it's essential for you to kind of go ahead and be able to control that. You know what I'm saying? I see like you got good people in your corner. Shout out, Rico. Shout you know what I'm saying? Shout out to the family. Shout out to the good people you got in your corner, man. That's keeping your head on your shoulders. That's keeping you level because you're working on your fitness.
Yeah, for sure.
Starting businesses, boy.
Facts.
You're about to leave a whole legacy out here.
Facts, for sure. For sure.
Yeah, I mean, if this 25-year-old you, where do you see yourself at? Shit, I don't know, 35? Where do you see yourself?
Can't put no limit on it.
Oh, yeah, you don't want to talk about it,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, we can't put no limit on it. It's going to be something big, but we can't, nothing.
Yeah,
just
yeah.
Something big, like something big. Like I say, this generation going to have his Jay-Z's and P. Diddy's and it's 50 Cent's and it's all them motherfuckers that done up however much M. So it's like, niggas better not sleep. Like, niggas better jump on the wave. Like, it's going to be some of us that turn into that. Some of this new generation. So you better jump on that wave and be one of them greats. You know what I mean?
For sure. What's different in this music that you putting out now than what you had before?
What's different is now I'll probably, like, take more time on it. Like, I'll actually, like, give you a little more of me. Then I used to just freestyle more and just jump in the booth and freestyle more. And a lot of that time, it was like I was on, and then it was different drugs. It was different.
Yeah.
But now it's like, right now I feel like it's more grown man. It's more where I'm going with it. It's more like fly young nigga shit, get money. It's more like, get be on your fitness shit. Be on. It's just flyer. It's just like, oh yeah, we doing something instead of crash dummy. I'ma still give you that because I got it in me, but yeah. I feel like the music done matured. Like,
I feel like it was Wiz Khalifa that said, they say all I rap about is bitches and champagne, but he was like, you would too if every day you saw the same thing. You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, you see things different now. You've been places that's you've never been before. Before,
like, I could rap about Dubai now. Like, I'm tired of rapping about the hood. I could rap about Paris now. Let me talk. Like, man, I could rap about Jamaica. I could rap about Columbia. Like, I travel. So it's like, I wanna bring that into the music. Have a motherfucker feeling like they in Dubai or they in fucking Africa or wherever the next place I might go or might be. You know?
What do you say to people that's like, man, we want that old Jackboy though, man? Then we like this Jack.
But with that type shit, I feel like I see that with every artist down there.
Yeah.
And you can't get caught up in that. Your fans gotta grow up with you. And then if you still on that old Jack, like if you still think how you think 2 years ago, you getting left behind. Like every year shit supposed to change in progress. It's like your hair, shit grow. Like you're supposed to grow. And then the shit don't stay the same. Like so you supposed to grow with a nigga or you know what I'm saying? Like, however, but, like, my fans, I feel like they supposed to just grow, like, or you supposed to see, like, damn, he getting further. Like, damn, this nigga got a restaurant now. Like, damn, I remember when I only heard about him saying a bit saying free Jackboy. Now this nigga got a restaurant, you gotta grow with me. Know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Grow with a nigga, yeah, for sure.
Nah, damn, I feel that for sure, for sure. Yeah. Because like Jay, you said, you ain't working this hard to stay the same.
Yeah, nah,
fuck
hell
we
nah.
Doing that. We think we doing all this to be on the same shit?
Yeah, then I'll be flagging to y'all if I give y'all. The old Jackboy was high, the old Jackboy was going through shit, the old Jackboy was broke, he was, this Jackboy like, it's a new one. I'm gonna teach you how to get some money now. I ain't gonna teach you how to crash. Some songs gonna be lit, still turn. You get the oh yeah flip, but it's like we growing. We growing.
Damn, we just said some shit right there.
For sure.
Said the old that one versus the new Jackboy. And they can expect that in the music. So when they tapping into the music, I bet they'll hear every bit of what you saying right now and feel that same way. Because you know a lot of people look up to you, Jackboy.
Yeah, for sure.
Whether niggas want to admit it or not.
Yeah,
it's niggas,
for sure. Big motivator. I be seeing them. They be showing and they be, you know what I'm saying? Even with the drip, you niggas be catching them. I be catching them boys, but it's be like, I know, like, I feel like, you ain't got to salute it, like,
yeah.
But I know, like, big motivator, like, I'm telling you, they own it, like, they own it. I fuck with every nigga I see doing something, because that shit motivate me even more, even if you ain't even doing it on my level, even if you ain't even thinking about no restaurant or no, you could be doing little shit, that shit motivate a nigga, like,
yeah.
I could be doing way more than you, but that shit is still motivate me. You could do more than me, that shit, like, I just love when a, especially Florida. Like, say another nigga from somewhere else, they'd be like, oh, all right, y'all doing y'all shit. But when a Florida nigga doing it, you just showing me it's possible. Know what I'm saying? That's all I need. Like, that's all I needed from the hood. Know what I'm saying? When I seen a nigga blow and show me it was possible, it was like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
We real deal could get to it. It's like, that's all I needed. You ain't got to give me no money, nothing else. Just motivate a nigga. Like, let me see how far we could get this shit. And I'm going to add and show you how far we could go, too. Know what I'm saying? I'm going to show you. I'm going to keep on pushing it. And you keep on pushing it. Like, and we going to see, like, how far, like, then this shit could get big, like, for a nigga from the crib, like, because regardless you from Florida, the biggest you get, I don't give a fuck where you from, Tallahassee, Orlando, Broward.
Yeah.
If you get bigger, you helping every nigga out in Florida. Know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
You just shining the light on this motherfucker. So keep on shining the light, my nigga. Know what I'm on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Hell
shout out St. Pete, shout out Jacksonville.
Shout out St. Pete, Jacksonville, y'all already
yeah,
know.
Yeah, yeah. Big old Duval, man. It's crazy, man, to see that your growth is, because Florida is once again behind you 100%, bro.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what
sure.
I'm saying? I know you feel that love everywhere you go.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
What do you want people from Florida to know that, like, yo, Jackboy will not stop going? Jackboy is going to always give you. What do you want to tell
Jack
Florida?
Jackboy ain't never going to not have that. He going to keep that shit in your face. You hear me?
Yeah.
I'ma always have that shit on. I'ma always have that shit with me. Like, I'ma keep that shit in your face. Like, I'ma stay in your face. Like, expect that. Like, every year. Like, damn, how the fuck this nigga? Don't be surprised. Don't act like damn. Just know I'm in your face. Just know even when I'm ducked in the cut, I'm working. Like, a nigga working. Like, regardless if it's music or something, I ain't laying down. Like, I'm working.
That's crazy, because sometimes people think that when they don't hear from you or they don't see you, that you ain't working.
You ain't
but really,
working.
That's when you fucking...
That's when you really in that mode. That's when you in that mode for the shit that comes 6 months down the line. You know what I mean?
And then they be like, oh, he just came out of nowhere. No, this nigga been training.
And this nigga been going hard. Nigga been focused. Like, this nigga been
locked
dedicated,
in.
Locked in. Like, hell yeah.
Yeah.
Dedicated, locked in.
What's crazy is before we wrap this thing up though, you've been training, you've been working out, you've been on your fitness, you've been killing shit. Yo, if you could give me a couple tips, I'm trying to get on my fitness out here for real. We talked about that broccoli.
For sure.
That's one of your go-tos.
Yeah, broccoli, eat the rice, nothing, chicken. I eat chicken every day I can.
If you can.
Yeah, like oatmeal too. Oatmeal for the breakfast. Throw a little banana in there.
So is that your pregame workout? Pre-workout.
Yeah, I eat oatmeal first, you know what I'm saying? Then right after the oatmeal, like after the oatmeal workout, drink you a little protein shake, a little muscle milk type shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Then after that, just so you can make sure you get enough protein in you. Then after that, you know what I'm saying? Get your broccoli in, you just eat good from there. I probably eat broccoli rice. After that, I might chill for a little bit, get a little acai bowl or something, man. Little fruit with the peanut butter in it, little shit like that. Then I go back to, hopefully, it's broccoli and rice again, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But you could switch it up. You could throw the steak in there. You could throw salmon in there. You just eat good.
Yo, you saw a lot of hood niggas probably like, man, what the fuck he talking about,
yeah,
man?
Hood niggas like, what the fuck this nigga, old healthy ass nigga? But it's like, better get on it. Like, that shit just added probably like 15 years to my life, you know what I'm saying?
You know, I always tell myself too, man, what am I doing today that's going to fuck me up for?
Exactly, for the future. Like, I'm going to be 50 still sexy to these young 30-year-olds, 20-year-olds. I'm going to still be 50, yeah, looking good, shirt off, all that. You got to care about the body. Like, this God temple, ain't it?
That's a fact.
So you better, like,
you
want to
get one of them too.
Treat it right. Like, he proud of me for treating this shit right, you know what I'm saying? So make that nigga proud, like... God looking like, oh, you holding my temple down. Like, you treating that shit right. Keep that shit up cap. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Don't be lazy with his shit.
That's a fact right there.
For sure.
The last thing you want to hear, I'm sure you like, man, damn, if you would have just ate a little better, you would have got 10 more years. You would have been able to live a little longer. You know, yeah. And we see that a lot. Is that the main focus is why you started working on your fitness?
Nah, you know,
what was the driving force for that?
Fitness help you with your mental, like, you know, my mind be all over the place, like, and sometimes I need to sit back and just focus, and it just help you with everything. Like, I feel like if you, like, whatever you, nothing, you got too much on your mind, or you just, nothing, like, just sit back, work out, get a good,
therapeutic.
Yeah, make you feel good, then it make you, not saying, if you waking up, say, you waking up just angry and you don't even know why you angry, just go get a workout in. I said, trust me, your day will feel better. You'll lose all that energy. Like, sometimes I be having too much energy, like, and it's like, after that workout, a nigga feel good. Like, damn, I ain't even got enough energy to argue with your ass right now. Like I'm gone. I don't give a fuck what you talking about. But some days, you know, people, I got enough energy today. Like,
I got time.
Yeah, yeah, I got time today.
I got time today.
Yeah.
Yesterday I had time, but today I got time.
I ain't work out now. I got time today. Yesterday I was.
Yo, no, that's a fact. That's
so,
a fact.
So, yeah, keep yourself busy, man. And you keep them busy. And while you don't, like, say, that's a good thing to be busy with because you helping your body out. You know what I'm saying? So it's work out early morning, then go get your day with. You know what I'm saying?
No.
It's a good thing to be busy with.
That's a fact. Well, Jackboy, dog, we done tapped in with a little bit of everything, bro. I'm glad you came here. I'm glad you in the Bay. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
I ain't no telling
shout
where you going
to
be at next.
Shout out to the Bay.
You know the Bay tapped in too, man.
Yeah, you know, I fuck with the Bay. I lived in the Bay for like down there 2 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
You know, me being from Florida, I'm learning the culture a lot.
Yeah.
They put me on to a lot of things, man. From the Bippy.
Yeah, don't leave nothing in the car, them boy.
You already hip.
Well, I'm hip, boy. I'm some bad motherfuckers, boy. Don't leave nothing in the car, boy. On nothing. You hear me? You hear me? That shit serious. Like, them boys going sprees. Like,
yeah.
Them boys going sprees.
That
like,
is crazy, bro.
I ain't leaving nothing in the car. Like,
yeah. Now you gotta be. I was walking up there. I seen somebody left a letter on the windshield. There is nothing in the car. The doors are unlocked.
All the doors unlocked. Don't break
the
window.
Don't break my shit. Cause
just go
the
in.
It's open, bro. Just don't make me have to pay $250 for a new window, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Them boys still break that shit.
Pah.
Fuck yo.
You know,
grab a baby bag in the back seat. You were like, you just grabbed a baby bag.
Well, number some towels in that motherfucker. But you know what, niggas, that's a full-time job for a lot of niggas out here.
Fat. That's, you know, a hustle though. That shit. Niggas be coming up. It be shit in them cars.
You know?
I done seen a lot of people.
If you hit 15 in one day, one of them might have some.
Them boy hitting 30 in one day. Them
boy. But you know,
hey, nah, yo, we can't promote that.
No.
Them boy about to, oh yeah, damn, 15 in one day. I'm about to get that.
Right. See what I'm saying? But you get where it's coming from, but
yeah,
man,
for sure.
Thank you for taking the time today,
already,
my man,
y'all.
For real. Just rock with Hoodclips.
Hoodclips, y'all.
We rocking with you.
For sure.
Big blessings, King.
Already. Appreciate love. You, love. I lost all feelings and sucked ass back to the hood.